Anastasakis, who is the scientific director at the Unit of Inherited and Rare Cardiovascular Diseases at Onassis Cardiac Surgery Center. Dr. Anastasakis will present the concept of our network.
Thank you very much, Professor Filippoulou. I'm trying to open my screen now. Can you see?
Yes, excellent. All right.
Thank you very much. So let's see what's the concept and where we are here now. Why we're here and where are we considering the network? There is a small story, actually, which shows how all this has started. A man in a tertiary center of Athens, he was diagnosed with a significant inherited arrhythmogenic disease. And he was treated properly, and he's still alive and in a very good condition. But 4 years later, after his management, his nephew, a young girl, died suddenly as he was dancing. When we went to the family and we checked the family, we realized that apart from the uncle, another person was had the disease of this inherited arrhythmogenic cardiac disease and was the father of that girl. And the diagnosis was arrhythmogenic right ventricular cardiomyopathy. Both the brothers had the mutation, and so actually it was obvious that in the family was running an inherited cardiovascular disease. We checked the mutation to the girl who has died, and we identified the mutation, and also through the clinical parameters we realized that we were facing a subclinical case of ARVC. A case that maybe it was easy to identify, or we had chances to identify if we had performed the family screening when we were facing the problem of the uncle 4 years before. Performing the genetic analysis on this family, we identify that the girl also, the victim, has the mutation, and we check the rest of the family, which fortunately nobody was affected, nobody else was affected. But this was the main idea, because the question that came us in our mind was, came to us was, could we prevent the death of that girl? And we believe that if we could do that, the benefit, we could multiply the benefit, because the families in Greece and in Europe are huge. So if you know the reason of a genetic disease, then you can perform this family cascade screening, and you can save lives. Also, we have the opportunity to cut the chain of the inheritance if we knew the causative mutation through the preimplantation diagnosis. So the benefit were many. And on the other hand, we had to discover a methodology how we're going to reach this high risk population, because those diseases have some certain peculiar characteristics. First is that sudden cardiac death can be the first clinical expression of the disease. We don't have prodromal symptoms. The second is that those diseases can, the clinical expression of those diseases are not always with the typical form. We can have subclinical forms, or we can have people that they carry the mutation and they can give it to the next generation. So it was a tricky problem. And also, those diseases can appear in clusters, like Naxos disease in the area of Cyclades. The average prevalence of arrhythmogenic cardiomyopathy of ARVC is 1 over 5,000, and in the island of Naxos is 1 over 800. So you see that there is a significant problem through this disease. And we tried to invent a methodology, and we realized that we could put this method in a general strategy of prevention of sudden death in the national level, where we have the athlete's card as a screening tool. We have the first aid in the community. And the thing that was missing is to try to identify, to invent a methodology to identify the high-risk population through the family history of sudden death of the family history of inherited cardiovascular diseases. Screening the families, we could identify people in the families that they could have the same problem. And this is exactly what we started to do. We created two registries, the inherited cardiac disease registry and the sudden cardiac death registry. We search clinically and genetically the family, and we identify the high-risk relatives. That is actually the project. And the implementation of this project was made by a consortium of university hospitals, of NHS hospitals, and in scientific institutions with molecular ability to molecular with abilities to perform molecular testing, like the ECETA, the Onassis genetic lab, the lab in the Institute of Technology in Crete. And so we were able now to work all together, trying to create a result which could be beneficial. So we use clinical protocols, we use a common language with common clinical protocols, with a common genetic panel and post-mortem protocols. And we try all together to work and have a collective result. So we have our results was immediate, because we were investigating the families, the patients first, and then the family of the patient. And so far, till the June of 2021, we have screened 2,061 patients with inherited cardiovascular diseases. 1,015 sudden death families are under evaluation. So the overall volume of investigation is 3,076 families under evaluation at the moment. And apart from the clinical evaluation, of course, we have the genetic evaluation and the cascade family screening. About we intend to screen about test genetically about 750 probands, and then 2,210 relatives in this part of the project. And of course, to working with all this material, we had to put this to have an infrastructure for this data. We had to have a clinical registry, a sudden death registry, and a genetic registry, which the Institute of Technology and Research of in Crete, in the University of Crete, take over and created a unique result, which Dr. Fundulaki is going to present it after my presentation, and actually gave us the opportunity to have the pathway from the clinical data to genetic results and backwards. And also, as you see here, we through this infrastructure, we have now referrals from all over the country, and the three major centers of Athens, Thessaloniki, and Heraklio are collecting all this data and they put it to the platforms. Also, the network has a training program, which like the use of ECG in the athletes, the athletic activity and the heart problems in the COVID era. But the main thing is that the training program that we create in collaboration with International Cardiomyopathy Network, using videos and animation. And I believe that by the end of this year, we're going to have a packet of this training result. But all this happens in what scientific environment? Let's see. Since 2014, the Hocking guidelines that was created under the leadership of Perry Elliott, for the first time, they put genetic as part of the management. At the same time, in DCM, we identify that through the genetic analysis that we have a preclinical and early phase apart from the clinical phase of the disease. Genetic is becoming a part of the restratification of dilated cardiomyopathy. And this fact is enforced and becomes even more significant in the case of arrhythmogenic cardiomyopathy in 2019. In the new guidelines of American Heart Association of hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, genetic has plays a significant role also. And last but not least, in the guidelines of heart failure, for the first time, they realized, the doctors of heart failure, that genetic counseling and genetic testing is very essential for the management of people with cardiomyopathies and heart failure. At the same time, in other parts of Europe, the dynamic evolution of this scientific field is gaining, and we move from phenotypic driven models of restratification to mutation specific prediction models. This is a paper very recent from Professor Wilde. And in this environment, we have some preliminary results of the network, which is, we know now that in Greece we have the mutations that are the causative mutation of hypertrophic cardiomyopathy are identical with the rest of the international literature. We have almost 70% is the genetic yield of the genetic test. In arrhythmogenic and dilated cardiomyopathy and myocarditis, we find 22% of high-risk genes in this cohort, which is a very significant finding and seems that genetic has a very significant role in the restratification. Also, we see that we have in areas of the country a founder effect. For example, here the PLN mutation has a high prevalence, especially in the settled Greece. We identify genetic links within the families from different areas of the country, and then we can further extend our cascade screening in these places. And finally, through the two registries, we identify that from the families that we have been, that have been tested genetically, 50%, almost 50%, they had relatives that were affected, and some of them, they had only the mutation, which means that it was difficult or almost impossible to identify them in another way. And also, we realized that the Greece is a natural park of inherited diseases because of the islands. Apart from the Naxos disease, which is a well-known case, we identify Cohen syndrome in Icaria, Wilson disease with cardiac involvement in Kalymnos, clusters of inherited cardiovascular diseases in Crete with amyloidosis, hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, and metabolic diseases. So we believe that the network has an added value. And the immediate results is coming from the Cascade Family Screening. We gain knowledge from the interpretation, the genetic interpretation. We have a common language, and we use a very really intelligent and friendly data infrastructure, which Irene is going to present this after my presentation. So I will finish saying that I want to dedicate to Irene Fudulaki this motto of Steve Jobs: the ones who are crazy enough to think that they can change the world are the ones who do, because of her contribution in this whole effort, which was really essential. Thank you very much.